Now, first reaction we have completed, in which we have distinguished aldehydes from ketones. Now we are going to see next reaction, that is chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones with nucleophile. Now, first reaction we are going to see is reaction with or addition of hydrogen cyanide or reaction with hydrogen cyanide. Now here, when aldehyde or ketone or any carbonyl compound, when created with hydrogen cyanide, that is HCN. Now in case of HCN, H is positively charged and CN is negatively charged. And we know that in the case of this carbonyl group, oxygen atom is more electronegative and therefore it withdraw electrons towards itself by inductive effect. And therefore this carbonyl carbon is positively charged or minor positively charged, and this oxygen atom of carbonyl group is minor negatively charged. And therefore addition of HCN takes place like this. This is positively charged, therefore CN goes attached to this carbonyl carbon and this hydrogen get attached to this oxygen atom to form RCOHCNR. This is cyanohydrin. Or here formation of cyanohydrin addition product takes place. Now we are going to see example. Now this is acetaldehyde or it is ethanol. Two carbon atoms are there, therefore it is ethanol. When this compound is treated with HCN, that is hydrogen cyanide, then this CN, which is negatively charged, get attached to this electropositive carbonyl carbon. Then pi electron shifts on oxygen and this get attached to this hydrogen atom. And we will get here CH3COHCNH. This is cyanohydrin of acetaldehyde, or it is also named as acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. Then second example with acetone. When this acetone is treated with HCN, then here addition of HCN takes place across this carbonyl group to form CH3COHCNCH3. This is acetone cyanohydrin. Second reaction with nucleophile is addition of sodium bisulfite. Formula of sodium bisulfite is NaHSO3. Now here, when aldehyde or ketone, when it is treated with sodium bisulfite, that is NaHSO3. Now we can write this NaHSO3 like this, HSO3Na. Here H is positively charged, SO3Na is negatively charged. Now addition of this sodium bisulfite takes place across the carbonyl double bond. Now here, this is electrophile. Therefore, this carbonyl carbon get attached to this SO3Na and this hydrogen atom get attached to this carbonyl oxygen atom to form RCSO3NaOHR. This is sodium bisulfite adduct. Adduct means addition product. Adduct. Sodium bisulfite addition product is formed. Now here we are going to see example. This is ethanol or acetaldehyde. When this ethanol is treated with this sodium bisulfite, then here this is hydrogen is positively charged, SO3Na is negatively charged. This SO3Na get attached to this carbonyl carbon, then pi electron shifts on oxygen atom, which is more electronegative, and then this get attached to this H plus to form CH3COHSO3NaH. This is acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite, adduct or addition product. Then second example, when this acetone or propane to ONE or propanone, when it is treated with sodium bisulfite, then here this negative part of sodium bisulfite, that is SO3Na, get attached to this carbonyl carbon, then this pi electron shift on oxygen atom, and then it get attached to this H plus ion to form acetone sodium bisulfite adduct. This is acetone sodium bisulfite adduct or addition product. Third reaction of aldehyde and ketone is with alcohol, that is addition of alcohol. Now here, when aldehydes or ketones are treated with alcohol, then here formation of hemiacetal takes place. Hemiacetal is unstable, and in second step, formation of stable acetyl takes place by the addition of second molecule of alcohol. Now we are going to see step first and then step second. Step first is formation of hemiacetal. Now here, addition of this alcohol takes place across the carbonyl group. Now here, RO is negatively charged and H is positively charged. Now here, this negatively charged RO group, that is alkoxy group, get attached to this carbonyl carbon. And then this H plus get attached to this oxygen atom to form RCOR dash H and here OH. This is hemiacetal. This hemiacetal is unstable. Now in second step, addition of second molecule of alcohol is carried out. Now this is alcohol and this is hemiacetal. When this alcohol reacts with this hemiacetal, removal of H2O takes place, that is this hydrogen atom and this OH is removed, and this R dash get replaced by this hydrogen atom to form RCOR dash OR dash H. This is acetyl. This acetyl is stable compound. This reaction is carried out in presence of dry HCl or dry acid. If we carry out this reaction with dilute HCl, then reversible reaction is carried out. For example, when this acetaldehyde is treated with ethyl alcohol in presence of dry HCl and dilute HCl, when this acetaldehyde is treated with ethyl alcohol in presence of dry acid, then here first formation of hemiacetal takes place, that is CH3COOH OC2H5H. This is hemiacetal, which is unstable. Then in second step, this hemiacetal is again treated with second molecule of ethyl alcohol to form CH3COC2H5OC2H5H. This is acetyl plus H2O. This compound is acetyl. This is stable. Now second example, when this acetone is treated with this ethyl alcohol in dry acid, then here formation of hemiacetal takes place, that is addition of this ethyl alcohol takes place across the carbonyl group. Here OC2H5 group get attached to this carbonyl carbon and H plus ion get attached to this oxygen, और कार्बोनिल ऑक्सीजन टू फॉर्म CH3COH OC2H5 एंड हियर CH3. दिस इज हेमिएसिटल एंड दिस हेमिएसिटल इन सेकेंड स्टेप इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू एसिटल बाय द एक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड इथिल अल्कोहल मॉलिक्यूल टू फॉर्म CH3COC2H5 and here CH3 plus H2O. Here this hydrogen atom or this OH group and this hydrogen atom remove as a H2O and this hydrogen atom is replaced by this C2H5 group and formation of this acetal takes place. Name of this acetyl is, now we are going to give name for this compound. Name of this acetyl is, now look here, first we give numbering 1, 2. At one position there is presence of OC2H5 group. OC2H5 means ethoxy group, therefore it is ethoxy group which are attached to one number carbon atom. And here there are two carbon atoms, therefore it is ethane. Therefore name of this compound is 1-1 diethoxyethane. Now we are going to give name for this acetyl. Now first give numbering 1, 2, 3. This is propane. At two position there are two ethoxy group. Therefore it is 2,2-diethoxypropane. That is name of this acetyl is 2,2-diethoxypropane. Third example we are going to see is formation of cyclic acetyl. Now here when ketone is treated with 1,2-diol or 1,3-diol, for example it is ethylene glycol, ethane 1,2-diol. CH2, and these two carbon atoms are attached to two OH group. Now here it is also named as vicinaldiol. When this ethylene glycol react with this ketone in presence of dry HCl, then here removal of H2O takes place. That is this OH bond breaks. Here this oxygen is also removed and H2O is removed, and then this carbon get attached to this OCH2 group, and this carbon get attached to this oxygen, that is COCH2 group is bond is formed, and here this carbon get attached to this oxygen to form cyclic acetyl like this R OCH2 plus H2O. This is cyclic acetyl. Now this cyclic acetyl can be converted into this ketone and ethylene glycol by the action of dilute HCl. That is, this reaction is reversible reaction if dilute HCl is used. Last addition reaction we are going to see is addition of Grignard's reagent. Now this reaction we have seen in alcohols, in the methods of preparation of alcohols. When aldehydes and ketones are treated with Grignard's reagent in presence of dry ether, then formation of secondary and tertiary alcohols takes place respectively. Now first we are going to see general reaction. This is ketone. When this compound is treated with Grignard's reagent, that is RMGX, then here this carbonyl group is, or this carbonyl carbon is positively charged, or it is electrophilic, and this oxygen is nucleophile. Now here this bond breaks. Here this alkyl group is nucleophile and this magnesium halide part is positively charged. Therefore this न्यूक्लियोफिलिक alkyl group get attached to this electrophilic carbonyl carbon, and then pi electron shifts on this oxygen atom, and then this electron pair get attached to this MgX to form magnesium complex, that is RCOMgX, here R dash and here R. This is magnesium complex. And this magnesium complex will undergo acid hydrolysis. That is, a hydrolysis is carried out in presence of acidic medium. Then here, this OMgX bond breaks. Hydrogen from water get attached to this oxygen atom, and OH from water get attached to this Mg to form RCRR-OH plus MgX-OH. This is tertiary alcohol. That is, ketones when created with Grignard's reagent gives tertiary alcohol. Now we are going to see example. Now this is acetaldehyde or ethanol. When this ethanol or CH3COH is created with this methyl magnesium bromide, that is Grignard's reagent, in presence of dry ether, then here breaking of this CH3MgBr bond takes place. This CH3 group is negatively charged, therefore it get attached to this carbonyl carbon. Then pi electron shift on oxygen and they get attached to this MgBr. Here formation of CH3COMgBr. Here also CH3 and here hydrogen atom. This is magnesium complex. This magnesium complex undergo hydrolysis to form CH3COH CH3 hydrogen plus MgBrOH. It is secondary alcohol. It is secondary alcohol. Name of this alcohol is propane 2-OL. Now we are going to see second example with acetone. When this acetone is treated with Grignard's reagent in presence of dry ether, then the CH3 group get attached to this carbonyl carbon. Then pi electron shifts on this oxygen. This oxygen get attached to this MgI to form magnesium complex CH3COMgI. Here CH3 and here also CH3. This is magnesium complex, and this magnesium complex when undergo hydrolysis in acidic medium, then here formation of tertiary butyl alcohol takes place, that is CH3COH CH3 CH3 MgBr MgiOH. This is tertiary butyl alcohol. In this way, aldehydes and ketones are converted into alcohol by using Grignard's reagent.